New Mexico is sort of an internet desert, a high desert, but a desert nonetheless. Solving the rural broadband problem and bringing higher speeds to cities is a big deal. And so far, it's the unsolvable riddle for New Mexico political leaders. You think about this all the years. They all pay lip service to the problem, but the pandemic has laid bare its impact. Last March, as the state pivoted to an online learning scheme, a fifth of students didn't have broadband. Now, Laura, the plaintiffs in the Yazzie Martinez lawsuit say the state hasn't done enough to help the vulnerable groups at the center of that suit get broadband effectively. Their motion said denying them not just equal education, but an education, period. What's your reaction to that?
I think they have a point. I think it's an important point that they've raised. You know, this is a lawsuit just by review that was filed quite a few years ago now, but it was resolved in 2018. There was a decision, and that was right at the very end of the Martinez administration, right before the election, the general election, where Michelle Lujan Grisham came in. But basically, the decision was that the state had an obligation to provide a fair, fully funded education for vulnerable populations, which included tribal members, racial minorities, Hispanic folks, disadvantaged students, as well as students with special education needs. And the state of the of education at that point was so dire for some of these vulnerable populations that it was important that the state figure out how to essentially equalize their resources better for those targeted at those school children and those particular school districts and areas that were most affected. But fast forward to where we are now, I don't think anybody could have anticipated how important it would be to deliver, to be able to have access to education through online means. Mm-hmm. We obviously at that point couldn't have anticipated that there was going to be this pandemic, that we were going to be doing so much online. A lot of these same students that were the plaintiffs or the subject of the plaintiffs in that case are once again falling through the cracks. They're once again falling behind dramatically from where they should be. And I think that's what they're raising. And it's a very important red flag to raise. And one that I do think that legislators are paying attention to because there's such a huge need in the rural areas for broadband. Mm-hmm. I know that Senator Michael Padilla, for example, has been a longtime advocate of trying to address this issue. He has been the chair of the Interim Committee on Science and Technology and has had many, many meetings with providers in rural areas, internet service providers and other telecom companies, and as well as the electric co-ops, some of which provide internet as well, to try to figure out how to expand rural access to rural broadband. And all of that is really going to be, I think, somewhat of an issue coming up in the session. There's definitely going to be some bills related to that. And I think it's something that the legislature needs to come together, both with educators and with technology providers, and figure out how to expand access.
That's a good point to that last point. Hey, Serge, you think about it. We've had a court drive education policy, and now it looks like we're going to have a court driving broadband policy in our state. I mean, what is it? And Senator Feld, I wanted you to follow up on this one, too. What's it say about our current and past governors, legislators, congressional people, representatives? Why did it have to come down to this, the court saying you must do this?
I mean, I think that you've hit it right on the head. This is, you know, as Laura said, this is not an issue that is a surprise to anybody here, right? In the state, the broadband access, the sufficiency of education issue, and the state, even the current administration has been saying, trying to get out of Yazzie, trying to get the case dismissed, you know, dragging their feet, rather than embracing this head on and saying, we're under court order to do this, but also this is the right thing to do for New Mexico, for education, for the people of New Mexico, for the economic future of the state. And instead, it is just kicking and screaming that this is all happening. And, you know, we're 9 months into this pandemic, and so many students have been lost, like literally, the school districts don't know where to find them.
That's right.
Yeah.
This is a crisis that should be a five-alarm fire. And if the state wants to fight Center on Law and Poverty and the Yazzie plaintiffs on their motion and saying, no, they need to do more, right? That's energy that needs to be spent in just addressing the problem.
Mm-hmm. Senator, your sense of that, why this has to be a court-driven situation and why our elected folks have not gotten their arms around this?
Well, I think it's a failure of leadership, frankly. In the legislature, in the PRC, which also has a share of this,
yep.
and in the governor's office. I mean, in 2005, the legislature appropriated $50 million to make sure that every school was connected to broadband, and using this thing called the E-rate.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the utilities also bear a big share in this problem, because they haven't been willing to spend the money to go that last mile
mm-hmm.
to connect folks in rural areas. So, you know, the legislature's been talking about it for years, and still there is no central agency that handles all of this. There is no actual assessment of how much it would cost to actually install broadband to 100% of the areas in New Mexico. The thing about this suit, which I think is great and needed, is that, remember, the judge said, Sarah Singleton said, it doesn't matter how much it costs the state, you must do it mm-hmm. in order to provide equal education to New Mexico's children. But in that's fine. But as a legislator, you still have to come up with the money to do it, and that has not been done. So it's embarrassing. But there are short-term fixes. There are short-term fixes that can be more money, so that I mean, even if the broadband is there, students don't, or families don't have the money to hook up, to
That's
pay
right.
the monthly fee. They don't have the laptops. They don't have, the teachers don't have the training and the IT departments to deal with this. So there is a possibility, I think, of like a short-term fix to this, even if the long-term really expensive thing is not possible.
Mm-hmm. You know, Merritt, I'm looking at the press release that came out of Tom Udall's office. New Mexico delegation hails $165 million grant funding to expand rural broadband access. And there's a big hoop-de-doo about all the money that's coming in, and a number of our rural cooperatives are getting a good chunk of change here. I mean, we're talking, you know, $2 million plus, $38 million for Continental Divide Electric Cooperative, $26 million for NM Surf Inc. I mean, there's a lot of dough flying around here. Would it be reasonable for people to expect this to be solved now within a reasonable period of time? Because the argument has always been, there's just not enough money to do this. Could we just stop this now and just get this done?
Well, and you've kind of framed this beautifully, because, and also to Senator Feldman's point, is this just another big capital outlay, and who's going to see where this goes?
Yep.
Of course, I have the ability to come into a flex space. I'm in uptown Albuquerque, being able to use broadband. But of course, I'm a teleworker, and I live in the East Mountains, and I really can't function as a teleworker. And everyone's saying, well, the teleworkers, they want to leave Silicon Valley. They want to leave New York City. They should come to New Mexico. They can't.
That's right.
We don't have the broadband. So this mm-hmm. should be a huge multiplier, starting with our children, starting with our children in rural areas, starting with our underserved children, starting with the populations identified in the Yazzie case. This should be a multiplier. I think it's going to take statewide teeth or mm-hmm. regulatory teeth. I think it's going to take the PRC. I think, you know, the trunk line that is so overpopulated that I feed off of at my house, that CenturyLink is pretty open about. Oh yeah, we should never allow the people that we have feeding off of your DSL line.
Right.
Well, why don't we lay more line? Mm-hmm. Well, no one's giving us money to do it. Oh, okay, but you are willing to charge us all $150 a month for 1995 level access speeds. I want to talk, it's going to take some individual innovation, and outside of this press release, outside of the Senate effort, the sacred wind effort in Sierra County, that came out in October. That's $6.1 million through the USDA. That's going to be go to 1,600 homes. It's going to be fiber optic. It's going to go to Sierra County, working with an electric rural cooperative. I have great hope for that because Sacred Wind has been doing cool stuff for over a decade. I don't know if you all are familiar with them. They're a tribal-owned organization, and they've been doing really innovative stuff with USDA for over a decade. It started with power and getting in standalone power units to rural homes on reservations.
Was that through the Rural Development Program? Am I remembering that correctly?
It was with USDA.
It was USDA.
And it was a solar plant panel on a concrete block that also contained a generator that was powered by propane. If the propane ran out, there was a battery. So you could power a 2,000 square foot dwelling with solar with the propane and battery backup.
Gotcha.
And it was off grid.
Yeah, that was something
were doing 10 years ago. And so now they've taken on broadband because they saw a need and no one else would do it.
That's a good point. So, boy, you know, I would encourage folks to go to the release from Mr. Udall's office. There's some serious dough flowing into this state now for broadband. I'm looking at a number of companies, one of them, ReSound Networks LLC, $59 million. It's a lot of money around these parts. SpaceX, $25 million, a lot of money. Let's get some broadband going. All right, up next, some answers to the bird die-off back in September.